With Halloween approaching very fast, we are doing a DIY pumpkin drone here at the channel. Last week we completed the basic build. Today we are going to fire it up, we are going to configure it and take it on its maiden flight. If you did not watch last week's episode, there's a link in the description below as well as a link to the parts used in the project. Welcome to Drones and Electric Unicycles, where we make weekly tips, tricks and tutorials to help you get the best out of your equipment. Consider subscribing so you don't miss out on the latest from me. This is where we ended up last time, with the unit ready for powering up. Let's fry it! Just kidding, the smoke is from an e-smoke. Alright, let's fry it for real. No blue smoke, that's good. And you know what, it's the smoke that makes the electronics work. As long as it stays inside, everything is good. By the way, it's important to leave off the propellers until the flight controller has been fully configured. If any of you is wondering if the use of electric strips is enough to fix the motors, it's more than enough. Actually, I've designed a weak point that will break in case of a collision. This has worked well in the past. The KK2 is a fairly simple controller that lets you configure directly on the board with the four buttons below the LCD, with no need for laptops or tablets. This is a good controller to learn the basics in DIY RC before moving into the more advanced stuff. I will not spend a lot of time of explaining the settings of the KK2 as there are many good videos on YouTube explaining this. Like this one from Illuminar RC with an easy to follow instruction how to do it. There's a few operations from his guide I want to show you. Calibration of the accelerometers. Make sure to put your quad on a level surface and select the option from the menu and keep your hands off until it's done. ESC or speed controller calibration. Once the basic parameters has been entered, we need to perform an ESC calibration to make sure the voltage speed levels of the motors are aligned. This basically eliminates any difference between each motor and speed controller. First, turn on the remote and push the throttle to the max. Second, hold down the button 1 or 4 on the KK2 controller and connect the battery. Listen for the beep and then push the throttle down to 0. And wait for the double beep. Release button 1 and 4 and KK2 confirms calibration is okay. Third, let's check the motor direction. The motors needs to turn in a specific direction to work in a quad setup. Seems three of the four motors are turning in the wrong direction. An easy way to check the motor direction is to attach a piece of tape to the shaft. Motor direction can be changed by swapping two of the motor wires. Yes, now all the motors are turning in the right direction. As the last thing, let's check the motor response. The motor that drops is the one that needs to speed up. Everything seems fine. Let's disconnect the battery and mount the propellers. An easy tip to remember is the text printed on the prop should be at the same side to the direction the motor is turning. And now I will go outside and do a quick test of the stick response before flying. Now testing yaw. Then we test the pitch. And finally the roll. Now we are ready for the maiden flight without all the bells and whistles to make sure that we have a stable platform. Let me throw in a question. Have you ever built a scary quad? What parts did you use and what flight controller did you use? Share your experience below with the Drones and Electric Unicycles community. The goal of today is to make the drone hover and adjust it so it doesn't drift too much. Remember, this drone does not have any help from GPS to hold its position. Basically, any drift needs to be adjusted through the remote on these small handles. We might also have to adjust a little bit on the PI settings for the KK2 controller to make it good. I ended up using recommended PI settings from a guy called Dennis Baldwin that has built a quad with identical components. Link can be found in the description. You might need to adjust it a little bit more. It's not difficult, but it takes time to get it perfect, so make sure to have a few extra batteries on hand. Does not seem we have enough thrust for a decent performance, So we have decided to swap the props to a bigger size, 1045. If that is still not enough, we need to go from a 3S LiBo to a 4S to boost the performance. Now I'm happy with the bass performance. Let's install the sound system. Now we're ready. Stay tuned and make sure to hit the bell notification below so you get notified when the next episode is online. Take care and see you on the next one.